Hey, what's going on, guys? Tyler here. And today I'm going to be going over the fees associated with being an FBA seller. Now, this could be a boring topic for a lot of you guys, but it is a super important one, and you're going to want to know where your money's going on a monthly basis in terms of the cost and what you're paying to Amazon to actually run your business. Otherwise, you might be kind of blindsided at the end of the month when you're like, wait, where did all my profit go? So I'm just giving you an overview on a way that you can get started on tracking these things. And there are softwares out there too that will pull all of this information, but it's still good to understand what these fees are, where they're coming from, and maybe where you can find them inside the actual Amazon Seller Central. There's actually a page on the Amazon Seller Central site that you can go to. I'll leave a link in the description below for that. And you can see here, it actually gives you all of the breakdown of all of the fees and kind of an explanation of what they are. There are some that are not in there, and I'll be going over one of them in this video. But you can see the selling on Amazon fees guide. This is, really good. You can go through and you can click on it and kind of understand what the fees are and when they apply. So the first fee I want to go over is the selling plan fee. And you can either sell for free and you get charged actually 99 cents per item when an item sells. And I've done like 500 orders this month, so I'd be paying $250. It doesn't make sense for me to not have the professional. It doesn't make sense for anybody who wants to be a serious seller not to pay the $39.99 monthly subscription fee. And that's just a one-time a month fee. And then it waives that 99 cents per item fee. So it's definitely beneficial to pretty much everybody probably watching this video to go ahead and get that professional plan once you start selling. Now, if you're just getting started and you don't actually have any products or anything like that, you don't need to sign up for that subscription fee until items actually start making their way into your Amazon store. And then once you start selling 40 items a month, basically, you're gonna wanna get that fee. There's also some other benefits too. If you wanna see the full breakdown, just use the link in the description below and then navigate your way to the selling plan comparison. And you can see, this full breakdown of everything here on the benefits of the professional account. So the most basic fee that you're gonna encounter when you're selling on Amazon, and this is whether you're fulfilling the item yourself or if you're doing fulfillment by Amazon, the most common fee is going to be the referral fee. That fee is just a set percentage based on the category of what you're actually going to pay to Amazon when you sell an item. So for example, you sell a $100 item, Amazon's usually going to take a 15% referral fee. It does vary based on category. But most categories are going to be 15%. So you sell an item for $100 and you're going to pay Amazon $15 and you're going to get 85 net from that actual sale. Now that's FBM. If you're doing FBA, there's also a FBA fee associated with that as well. But if you're interested in more of like which categories actually charge what percentage, there is a breakdown on in that link for if you go to referral fees. Then you can see here, like I said, most of the common ones, like the very common ones, are going to be 15%, and some of the lower cost items it's going to be less, and some of the digital items and things like that are going to be more. But in general, it's usually around 15%. So the next fee that is pretty basic when you're selling on Amazon using FBA is going to be the fulfillment fee, also called the pick and pack fee. And that fee is going to be charged whenever Amazon takes one of your items and actually ships it to the customer and they do the fulfillment for you, hence why it's called the FBA fulfillment fee. And there is a chart, if you go to the link, there is a chart that you can go to and you can see the breakdown. So it varies by product type and it varies by the product tier. So like standard size versus oversize. Oversize obviously going to be more because it costs more to do, but then it also varies on size. So the less the item weighs, intuitively, it's going to be less for Amazon to ship it to the customer, so you're going to get charged less. So that's how that fee works. And if you need to see a preview before you actually decide whether or not a product is for you or not, like when you're doing your product research, most of the softwares do have that in, like most of the Chrome extensions, they have that in there where you can see based on the dimensions of the product and the product description, they'll go ahead and calculate what that fee is going to be. So you know exactly what you're going to be paying ahead of time. There also is a Fulfillment by Amazon revenue calculator you can use. And I use this tool a lot when I'm sourcing products. Basically, all you have to do is drop a ASIN into the revenue calculator. So I just picked a random one off of the homepage on Amazon. And you can search for it. You don't even have to enter any information here. You can just see that the Fulfillment by Amazon fees for this particular product are going to be $6.88. Once your items are actually in Amazon, you will be charged storage fees, and these also vary just like the FBA fees. And these actually vary based not only on size, but also what time of year it is. Right now we're in Q4, where Amazon views their inventory space in their warehouse. They view it much more valuable because a lot more sellers are sending things in. Prices generally might be higher in Q4 because there's more demand from customers. And basically, Amazon just wants you to move your products very quickly because they're going to be doing so much volume. So last month, I paid around 1% of my gross sales in storage fees. And I was actually talking to a few other sellers, and usually that fee is around 0.25% to 0.5% of your gross sales. So my fees were, you know, almost four times as high as what someone else could expect during another time of the year. And like I said, that's just because Amazon views that space as much more valuable. So it's not a huge fee when you know you add up at the end of the year what it is compared to your overall sales, but it's still a fee that you want to be aware of. And that long-term fee is going to be even higher than this one. So you want to make sure you're moving your products quickly. So a fee that you're going to run into when maybe an item is just not selling and you just want it out of your inventory because you're incurring fees, like long-term storage fees or whatever, and you just want that product out, or it's a product that has been returned and is unfulfillable again. So you know, you need to either have that item shipped back to you, or you're just going to let Amazon dispose of it. For most of my items, for the returns, I actually just let Amazon dispose of that particular item. I have no way currently of reselling the product on any other marketplace. So for me, it's not really worth it to pay the fee to have that item shipped back to me when I could just pay this fee here and have Amazon actually dispose of it for me and take it completely out of my inventory where I don't have to worry about it anymore. This is another fee that obviously varies based on the weight, but it is a very cheap fee. Keep in mind when you dispose of your product, you obviously are losing the full cost of the goods sold. So yeah, just another fee that you want to be aware of for your FBA business. So if you go to the transaction view in your actual settlements page on your Amazon seller account, you will be able to scroll through the transaction type and just click service fees, update. And you can see for all my settlement periods, you can actually see these fees that I'm talking about. And this one, inbound transportation charge, this is going to be whenever you ship something into Amazon, they'll actually create a label for you and then just charge your account. I did a little analysis on this, and it comes out to about 50 cents per unit on average for me. If you're shipping in the same stuff over and over and over again, then obviously it's very easy for you to know how much the products weigh, the size, all of that, and how much Amazon is actually going to charge you. For me, I have my two biggest shipments were 270 units. I had two of those. One of them was $68, the other was $158. So it really depends on the products that are being shipped in and yeah, just the size, weight, etc. But that's going to be the inbound transportation charge. You can see that, you know, I have a bunch of those because I've been shipping a lot of stuff into Amazon. And then here's the subscription fee that I talked about for my professional selling account. It's going to be $39.99. I do have a disposal fee of 35 cents for one of my items. And then I have some FBA removal order fees, return fees, etc. So yeah, you can see that you can see most of the fees in that breakdown of the statement view. But some of them you're gonna have to dive a little bit deeper to see the fee. And one of those is actually called a refund admin fee. And I'll go ahead and break that down for you right now. Now I wanna look at a return that happened on my account and break down the fees associated with this return and how much money I ended up losing from the return. So if you look at the transaction types here, you can see one that says order payment. That was 11/18/2021. And then on 11/20/2021, this person decided that they wanted a refund. So they got a refund. And if you look at the fees associated with each one and the totals, you can see that when I sold the product, I only got $5.04 net. But when I did the refund, or Amazon did the refund on my behalf, I ended up losing $8.81. So total, that is a discrepancy of, I'm going to say $3.77, but let's just do the math real quick just to make sure so we can get the numbers perfect. So yep, $3.77 is the difference there. So essentially I lost $3.77 on this, plus the cost of the goods sold. Now let's go inside the two orders and actually figure out where that discrepancy comes from. So you can see here when I sold the item, I had a pick and pack fee of $3.47. You don't get that back when someone returns the item. So I can subtract $3.47 from that. That leaves me with 30 cents. Okay, so now I need to figure out where did the other 30 cents go to. If we go back here, we can see that there is this refund administration fee on the return page. There's the 30 cents right there. And how that's calculated is it's going to be 20% up to $5 of the referral fee. So the maximum, you know, if you sell something for $200 and Amazon takes 30, the referral fee, you know, the refund administration fee on that referral fee is only going to be $5. So yeah, it's just up to 20% or $5, the less of the two. So obviously I didn't cover 100% of all of the fees associated with selling on Amazon. I basically just cover the ones that you're going to probably run into the most. And if you want to learn more about all of the fees that are associated with selling on Amazon, then use that link in the description below and go to this Selling on Amazon Fees Guide and really get yourself accustomed to it, because it is very important if you want to run a solid business and understand all aspects of selling on Amazon. Thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber, please subscribe and don't forget to hit that like button. Thanks, guys.